How do you feel?
My head's pounding like I got hit by a fucking train. It's like we're still here, partying and stuff. Yet I feel like it's tomorrow and I have a hangover. Like a time-traveling alcoholic.
That sounds like some deja vu.
Yeah, I think it's all this fucking country music in every bar we go to. It's giving me a fucking headache. Fucking twangy bullshit.
I guess they only have honky-tonks out here in this part of the world.
Answer me this, man. Are we really going tomorrow with the girls on some stupid hike? Let's just hang around town. Like, there's enough bars around here to last us a few days, and then we can call it a day and go home.
What are you talking about? This whole vacation was your big idea.
First off, it wasn't my idea. It was the other one, she who shall remain nameless. I'm just following along.
You mean Tina? Come on.
Shh. She might hear us.
Stop joking around. We're all having a good time. Even you.
I'm being very serious. It's not like I have some problem with a little romantic double date in the country. What I'm starting to have a problem with is roughing it every other day. I mean, come on, Jim. We're city boys. I like concrete and stoplights and civilization. I'm not dealing with some fucking hicks in the middle of nowhere for a week straight.
What are you going on about?
Look, face it. Like, my girl wants to take this detour, middle of nowhere, to look at some stupid rocks. So she drags your girlfriend along, and then they drag both of us along like a couple of dopes.
So you're leading the mutiny.
Somebody has to. I mean, look, right now, I feel like turning that car around, the nearest couch I can find, and just working on a few cold ones the rest of our holiday.
Okay. Then how about this? Let's go back to the hotel right now, and you can break the news to Tina. Go ahead and do it, Mr. Tough Guy. Go break that poor woman's heart. I'll back you up.
I'm ready to go yet. We got a long day ahead of us, so.
I was ready an hour ago.
All right, let's kill these first. A toast to interesting adventures with friends and lovers. May they never end.
Lisa.
Where were you all night?
I
was practicing for the point in our relationship 3 years from now where we both ignore each other. We stayed at the bar because Rex wanted to get a few more drinks in. You guys should have stayed with us.
We retired. Asshole. Get away from me. Go freaking brush your teeth. Go.
I thought I heard some noise down the hall before I came in.
It's nothing, I just had a bad dream.
About as good as I could with the air conditioner busted in my room, and Tina kept me up all night with her shifting around, snoring, singing, marching. You know the routine.
You're the one that walked in the room at 3 o'clock in the morning waking me up. You're a real jerk, you know that?
I know I need some more bed. You guys ready to go see some rocks and hills and stuff?
Shut up. It's gonna be cool.
I'm sure it is. Are we all checked out, Jim?
Officially checked out and ready to go. Why don't you drive while I get some sleep?
Sure, let's go. I just noticed something.
What's that?
We've been on this road trip a week now, and Jim and Lisa have spoken a whole total of 2 sentences combined. We're really picking up a lot of the slack when it comes to the road conversation.
That's rude, you know that? They're not
just kidding.
People.
Jimmy's always been...
They're not loud and annoying like you, the guy who always
what?
Has to get
wow.
away.
Wow, loud and annoying? Really?
Yeah.
You better check yourself. I wasn't loud and annoying until I met you.
Oh.
You corrupted me.
Wow, okay, let's just drop it.
It's dropped.
So, do you want to know more about where we're going?
Yeah, not really.
Well, it's called Enchanted Rock. It's a mountain with lakes and caverns located in Briar Lake Forest Preserve. According to this, the locals avoid the forest for miles. It was settled in the 1800s, and all kinds of weird things started happening. They say it's haunted.
Wow, sounds like a great place to fuck around with, honey.
Enchanted. Huh. What a funny name.
Sounds like where leprechauns hide their gold.
Lisa, where do you think a name like that comes from? I don't know. Are you okay? I mean, you seemed so excited about this hike when I brought it up, and now... I guess I'm just getting tired from all this traveling.
You can say that again.
Shut up! Hey. someone in the road.
So are you boys just out trucking around?
Vacation.
Shoot, there ain't nothing wrong with that. This is a good time to be trucking around.
If I had the time, I'd be trucking around myself.
You know about this Enchanted Rock place?
Oh, yep, I do. Folks around town don't talk about it much, though.
All right. Are we on the right road, at least?
Oh, yeah, you're on the right road. You just keep following that there road, and it'll take you right there. There's a little trail runs alongside the road just as you get outside of Bryant. Keep following that trail, and it'll take you right to the top of the rock. I haven't known anyone that's been up there for years, since the old mill closed.
Is it safe up there?
It ain't safe anywhere anymore, mister.
Oh, hey, thanks, man.
No sweat.
Anybody seen Lisa? Where'd you run off to?
Was it going very well?
Yes, DJ, you can go play. Just make sure we can see you, okay?
Okay.
I'm gonna go get some firewood, okay? I'll be right back.
Lighter fluid.
Your speed bump, when you think of sin, you need to think of it like an infection. As Christians, when we come across a negative influence, those who are not under the influence of God, but under the influence of something far darker, those who are without faith, we must make a very important decision for our family, whether we want that sin to grow and infect our loved ones like a cancer, or if we need to cut off from these people to save our community. Folks, we all know that the world these days is awash in a sea of sin. Waves of young people turning away from God, marching, displaying themselves and their sins in front of God Almighty.
Could you turn that off, please?
Block, lay your sins at the foot of the cross. M.C. Watson, for the ever.
Taking your phone with you?
It's dead.
Looks like we're here.
This has to be the place.
There was a gate.
Yeah, I like to think of it as a suggestion that you might want to stay out.
Are you sure we should go in there?
What, do you want to turn around and get out of here?
No.
Great. Who's got point?
What's point?
Who goes first?
Well, why didn't you just say that then? Who goes in first?
I got point. What the hell is this?
Must be that old mill the guy at the store was talking about.
I wonder who used to work out here.
I have some tough lumberjack types? Or the Unabomber's cousin?
I see something inside there.
Hey, Jim.
Look at this. There's a backpack and some other stuff inside there. Like somebody was camping out. Looks like they left in a rush. Come on, let's check it out.
Rex, come here. Look at this.
What?
It's an invoice for some tools from 1925. Huh. This place is old.
Yeah.
Guys, check this out.
Let go of me.
What'd you see over there?
I didn't see anything. I just need to be left alone.
Thank you. Hey. Will you tell me what's going on? Ever since we started this trip, it's like you're holding something back from me. You can tell me anything. It's Rex, isn't it? Look, he can be an idiot, but he's had my back for a long time. He's a good guy.
No, it's not Rex. I like Rex.
Is it me then? Is this something I'm doing wrong? It just seems like we were having this great time. We planned this trip and now you're being all distant.
Where are you going?
I think I'll look around.
Where are you really going?
Nature calls. I gotta go take a leak. Is that specific enough for you?
Look out for the bears. They say they like to eat little girls who misbehave.
Fuck you.
Okay, I thought you got lost out there.
Where's Tina?
She went to the little girl's room a little while back.
Maybe you should go look for her. It's easy to get lost out there.
Yeah, you're right. All right, I'll be back. You guys stay here.
You don't want us to go with you?
No, it's okay. She probably just got lost looking for the nearest restroom or something. You guys hold down the fort. I'll be back.
Getting dark soon.
Well, guess I better hurry then.
fucking girl. She's gone after the one mom liked. Tina!
Hey, Tina! Stop fucking around, this isn't a joke!
You so deserve to be put over somebody's knee and spanked.
Tina!
Rex! Tina! Rex! Rex! This isn't getting us anywhere.
We can't just leave him here. We have to find him!
Why are you so panicked?
I just had this bad feeling, Jim. As long as we're in these woods, we're all in danger.
That's weird. The watch stopped.
What's going on? Where are we?
Tina, is that you?
Yes, I'm here, Rex.
Are you okay? What happened? Where the fuck were you?
All that matters is that you're here now, and I need you. Come to me.
You hear that? It's raining, but there's no rain.
do you think those things are?
I need to tell you something. Look, I've been hiding something from you.
Yeah.
I've tested positive twice and I'm pregnant. But it's not yours.
This was all because of me.
Thank you.
Congratulations, Elizabeth. You finally made it to the other side of the mirror. Quite an accomplishment. After all, it's where you've always wanted to be, isn't it? Free from responsibility, free from a past, divorced from reality itself. There's not a better place that you could find yourself, Elizabeth. Not a better place. It's a pity that you're so fixated on some of the older fragments of your consciousness. Maybe I should take on the image of one of your happier memories. Hopefully that should spark some passion within you.
Thank you. Yeah.